No time for introductions. Things are happening. Oh God. Hello, if you've just joined us, the lusty Argonian maid Constantina is on the run from a thief. What are we going to do about that? I'll tell you what we're going to do about that. We're going to level up. Hello. Now we'll do introductions. I'm Jim Sterling. This is Skyrim by Committee, the game where you tell me how to play Skyrim. When I level up, people give me the options where I'm going to go. They vote in the comments using a comment thread that, so far, the commenter Askifin has taken it upon himself to organise things where I wanted chaos. And he's made a big comment chain in each of my videos where people are voting for where I should put my attributes and my perks. So, as per the voting at the end of the last video we did, people voted by a huge margin for me to up my Magicka. So that's happened. And it was a close run thing between Speechcraft and Destruction. But it seems people had their fun watching me desperately struggle with illusions. Oh, no. There. And Destruction. We now have the power to fight back directly. Thank you. And we're going to do just that. Yes. Oh, wrong one. What? Oh, shit. Well, we're not going to use any of the speech options. Now, I know last time I said that if you don't put anything in Speechcraft, I won't even do so much as selling and buying items. Yeah, we're going to scrap that. That was a silly idea. But we will not use actual speech options like this, like Intimidate and Persuade, until Speechcraft is leveled. So, because that's how I'm going to play it. I play determined... let's try and talk sensibly. My gameplay is determined by the perks you put in. So, I'm still going to use some illusion, but obviously I'm not going to do anything more advanced than novice until that upgrades, until you decide that I'm going to do more in the illusion tree. So I'm only going to use the illusion stuff that I've bought so far. I'm not going to buy any more. Destruction you've given me, I'm going to do be very destruction-led in this game. And I think that we'll feel out the rest as we play. So anyway, all we can do is I'd rather die or I don't have time for this. Oh God, why am I pressing the wrong one all the time? There! Oh, it's nice to have power. Yeah, she's fucking me up. Well, that was a bit ironic considering I'm burning you. Okay, it's time, I think, to hist skin it up. We can use hist skin because that is our want. There we go. Burn. Burn, I say! Now, we're still a magic user. Now, what that means is weapons I'm not using until, obviously, I get perks in weapons. I will take things to sell. You know, with this lockpick, no use to me as a thief. I'll take the armor, but can't use it. The mage hood I can use. That's if it won't mess with my vampire armor. I don't think it does. So we have a mage hood with our vampire armor. Now, if you have just joined us, you might wonder why I'm wearing vampire armor. I'm wearing vampire armor because I'm a vampire. One of the first things that happened to us in our game was I got attacked by a vampire and contracted the old Vampiros Sanguilarius. And I don't have official voting for actual things to do within Skyrim, but a very popular upvoted comment was that I should remain a vampire. And that's what we're going to do. So far we are an illusion and destruction specializing female Argonian vampire called Constantina. And we're having a bit of a wander around. Mud crabbing it up. Destruction increases. Good, good. We are not... Why is my dog barking? That stupid... butt-faced dog. Gonna burn this elk. Feel bad about that. It's a nest there, beehive. There's a bee inside. Lovely old bee. Yeah, we're gonna leave that. Constantina knows nothing of bees. For Constantina! It's a vampire with burny hands. Oh yeah, it's very burny hands. Wolfs. Oh my god, where's... There. For some reason the fucking... Now, one thing I did install, mod-wise, was, I forget the exact name of it. It's the mage... apocalypse something? Stuff that adds in a whole load of magic spells. Because one of the commenters was quite adamant I did that. And I will be taking mods under advisement. I've only got a few little graphic-y ones so far. But we will do a mod special episode at some point where I will just install everything that's requested. It might destroy the entire game, which is why I'm not doing it yet. I have a feeling if that goes wrong, that could be the last episode, and indeed the last time I ever get to play Skyrim. So we're kind of wandering around with no rhyme or reason at the moment. We may end up in a case where we level up more than once. And that'll be interesting, because obviously rather than have the videos end up too short, there will be instances where I level up more than once in a video, I'm sure. And what that'll mean is we'll have to decide two votes at once, and I'm not sure how we'll do that. Because obviously the easiest thing to do would be to just take the two top most voted comments. But where that leads us is what if you wanted me to do two things in the same thing? Like what if you wanted me to upgrade my health twice? If I end up with two attribute points, but you can only vote for one of them. I think maybe the first thing to do, and of course I'm going to let the commenters sort that all out, because you're the ones that seem to want organisation. I never wanted it. I didn't ask for this. What you might do is have Askifin or whoever else wants to do it, basically just put everything twice or as many times as I've levelled up. So there will be two entries for destruction. There will be two entries for alliteration, I was going to say? Alteration. Why are they attacking me? They're just hunters. Fuck, we're gonna get mullered here. I don't want it to be the end for me. I'm a mere... Is it because I'm all vampire? That's an arrow in the head! Oh, it's gone. What was I saying? Oh, town. Little village thing. Yeah. And other words that I was saying. Yeah, so that might be the best way of doing it, but as always, I'm gonna let you do it because I'm not here to make your life easier. Just as you're not here to make my life easier. Although you have, with the help of destruction, you have made my life easier. And I think the high votes for speech were trying to do that as well, trying to get me to obviously be able to buy and sell items, which we're gonna do. And I'm gonna use health potions and stuff. I've decided what I'm gonna do with the potions thing is I'm gonna use the three main potions, health, magicka, stamina. Anything more advanced than that, to actually be a potion user, a poison user, that I will use if you vote for alchemy. You know, it'll be up to you. Talk to Relda.
Get out of line and you'll have them to deal with. Do I detect a bit of jealousy in your tone?
Not really, I don't like farms.
What calling could be more noble than this? I see in your eyes that you think I jest. I assure you I don't. I am proud and...
The High Elf voice actress always sounds very bored. I know she's trying to sound haughty and arrogant. Your hands, seeing your seeds, she sounds sleepy.
Tending a herd. There is a joy in honest labor you won't find elsewhere.
Alright, bye.
Until next time.
Talk to this important looking fellow.
Are you feeling sick?
It's the town of Rorik's name
yes,
for you.
That's right. Look around you. Most of the lands you see are mine. Most of this I purchased while my comrades were fighting in the south, helping the Empire against the Old Mary Dominion. Back then, nothing would grow here.
I always mishear Old Mary Dominion as All Mary, and then it sounds like a great place. Come join us in the All Mary Dominion. Anyway, he's got nothing of interest for me. Rorikstead. Oh god, he's after me, isn't he?
By order of the Yard, stop right there.
Okay. Back to jail. We will wait out our time. We are not thieves. We are not sneaky burglary types. Not at this current juncture. We just want to be an honest mage. But so far, we have ended up in jail twice. Got all my stuff,
guess.
Though.
Someone stole your sweet roll.
Yay! First sweet roll reference of the game. Whee! Okay, well, we're back in Whiterun. But that's fine. We got plenty to do here. Buy and sell things. Oh, actually, fuck. I know I've just gone all the way down here. But we got the mage fella all up in the club here. And he has spells. We can buy some destruction spells. We will buy no more illusion spells for the moment. If you want me to buy more illusion spells. I basically have to do everything I want destruction-wise until the next vote. If I don't have it by the time you vote, and you don't vote destruction again, I'm buggered. I think that's a nice restraint.
What are you still doing here?
Obviously, we're learning as we go with this. I'm going to have ideas. Shut up. I'm going to have ideas that I think are good, and then we won't know till we put them into practice whether they'll be good or not. So things are going to change, and all the changes are going to be made in. In the name of making a more fun video.
To master the arcane arts.
So, books, spells. I haven't got much gold. Let's sell out. Shit. I've only got. I might have to actually come back here. Okay. Can't do any of that. Can't do any of that. Destruction is what we want. Where's the little book with the thing on it? Creeping cold. Yeah, value 3. Fuck. It's silly of me to come up here.
With you. The Jarl is not a patient man. Neither am I.
Obviously, wouldn't be a good Skyrim game if we didn't do that.
All this standing around is rubbish. We should be taken to fight to the Stormcloaks.
Good, good. Obviously, we gotta do this. It's tradition. I quite liked the one guy who said, I've gotta eat all the cheese I find. I might do that. It's like, as soon as you find cheese, immediately eat it. So we'll do that, actually. We'll have the cheesy Argonian vampire. Okay. Food. Cheese. What a yummy time we're having. Hmm. So, we're still a vampire, which is quite good, because vampires are more magic-oriented. I've got Draugr on here as well. I was disappointed with the vampires in Draugr. I chose vampires in Draugr on my old game, but my old game was a very physical character. So I made the wrong choice there. Eventually, I think I switched to werewolf in the end for that. But I was looking forward to being this cool, badass vampire bat monster. And instead, I,
It is a Dargonian.
Oh god, I can't go to jail again.
You know what's wrong with Skyrim these days?
Sell things to Bellathor. So yeah, I'm looking forward to maybe trying to play around with the vampire of the more magic-oriented character. That's if the character stays magical. I don't want to influence your voting. Yeah, a bit of this and a bit of that. Weapons. No use for weapons, and no use for armor. Potions. Keep that. Didn't have the vampire dust, why not? Okay. Still got enough to get a.
Do come back.
Any weapons and stuff.
I'd even buy one of your.
Right. There are some questy things. Isilda, who you can marry. I think I married her before in the game.
Before my Ma and Da passed.
Ma and Da.
One day, I'd be
best trade in Skyrim.
Caravan leaders, Madron.
Madron.
Said he'd help me get started. Mammoth's bring him a. You do that? If you find one, I could teach you a thing or two about trading. Help you get a fair bargain in the future.
Okay, so we can do that. She's got something, hasn't she? Yeah.
Mikhail is begging for a. I heard him boasting at the Bannered Mare, saying he'll conquer me as a true Nord conquers any harsh beast. If you want to try, go right ahead. I don't think anything.
Can't really do much about Mikhail because that leads to a punch up, and I'm not a punch up guy.
Face it, Calum. Your stupid son is dead.
Gendered.
He died a storm cloak traitor, and you.
Isilda, you can't have a conversation with me over angry man.
Come on, father. Oh,
is that argument all about?
It's not my fault they turned their backs on the Empire or their mule of a sun raised arm, and yet
okay.
They want to heap the fall on the family's good name.
There's a again, I don't think we've got the money yet to hire someone, but you can hire people in. Yeah.
I'm a bard by
this
trade.
One, I believe.
Think you could go blade a blade with me? You'd be dead in 6 seconds.
Oh no, that's the punch up. We can't really punch
good.
Up.
Wanna hear a little Nord? The
not
heat
really
of the battle. That and a true Nord never misses a chance to test her worth.
Today's come and gone.
The security in White One is terrible. Shameful is what it is.
Mm-hmm. And of course there's the what do they call themselves. I've forgotten a lot about this game. The mercenary, the fighters, guild stand-in. I keep wanting to say the brave companions, but they're the mercenaries in Game of well, say Game of Thrones, the Song of Ice and Fire books.
You tried mercenary work?
My sapphire doesn't like
you
that I've been spending
about?
So much time looking for my father's old sword. He fed his entire family with the gold he made using that weapon. I'm not about to let it gather dust in some thief's trophy room. I tracked it to a group of bandits nearby, but I'm no fool.
I think it's just the companions.
Guards, or maybe hire the. I don't know why I'm saying this, but if you find it out in your travels,
we can do that.
Wrong with Skyrim these days.
So there's the companions' place. You're normally meant to find them outside of Whiterun, but we seem to skip that bit. I don't know if that matters or not.
Those two at it again.
Yeah, there we go. I've never not met them outside the city before.
Nice.
Anyway, they're gonna kick the shit out of each other.
Not now. I'm trying to watch this.
Right. Okay, well, while they do that, obviously we've got our own business to attend to.
Fight.
probably be in bed. You're looking a bit under.
Whee! There we go.
Is
that's
Grimorham
a business.
I'm waiting.
Can I join
we
the companions?
Any milk drinker who stumbles in. Talk to Kodlak if you think you have what it takes to be a companion.
Damn right.
The Empire surrendered to the old Mary Dominion. They shamed us all.
I haven't seen your face before.
Oh, I'm just a servant here.
You put down.
My brother Vilkas is a better talker than me.
Oh,
he should be
that.
Around someplace.
Anyway, we should actually, let's just pick one of these quests today. Miscellaneous. Well, fuck it, we'll do the companions. Although that will make us a werewolf, and that will cure the vampirism, doesn't it? Let's not do that. Let's look for the sword. We'll do the sword. Oh, that's not marked, is it? I'm gonna do something marked, I'm gonna wander around. Talk to Mikhail about Kalana, speak with the leader of the companions. Right, in that case we'll just do the main quest for a bit. Let's see, can we get anywhere nearer to where we gotta go? Oh, not too near. Still got the Stone of the Mage activated there, so that's good. Mew. I've never played Nargonian before. They can breathe, can't they, under the water? That's nice. Not that the undead should need to breathe.
It's so nice to have a visitor. It's so nice to have a visitor.
The alchemist fucker. Right. We continue on our merry way. On our old merry way. Ah, Bethesda Mountains. How I missed ye. But there's the thing. When I first played this game, the very first time I played this game, eons ago, I totally missed the actual pathway up this mountain. Had the worst time ever trying to find a way up here. The official path should be around the corner somewhere. Who's this tit?
Never should have come here.
Scavenger, eh? Well, that's the end of you, you crispy fuck. Let's see, battle axe, bow. Haha, now you are a nude fucker. What were you doing with this nude fucker? And that nude fucker. What am I doing with this nude fucker? I was gonna just throw him in the river, but fuck it. The river is far, and he is heavy. And nude. Here we go. You cook a rabbit. Come on now, hardly raw.
It's a bad time to get lost, friend.
Constantinus in town. Yes. Ban! Ban! You tit. Yes. Wonderful. Yes. I'm doing my evil vampire lizard voice. That's how they sound. That's how they sound. We've got 20 gold. Not bad. As we loot and plunder. Ladies, loot and plunder. Not the more commonly heard loot and plunder. The bad guy from Captain Planet. And the bespoke planeteers. 73 gold. Not bad for a day's work. Pop around, bloop, bloop, bloop. Okay. Let us continue on our merry adventure. Follow the wavy flaggy flag. Now, when it comes to dragon shouts, we determined on the last video that once I get them, I will use them. That is an inherent skill, not really determined by anything. Yeah, it's good to have some destruction. Yes, it is. Archer over there. Let's have a look. Where's my weight? Let's carry weight. I got plenty of weight. As I've got plenty of weight, so there's an opportunity for a fat joke for you that you could have made at the expense of my misspeaking there. Have it if you want. I'm gonna burn this fucker. There we go. The executions don't really work for magic, considering it is just more of the same. It's not like they suddenly start screaming, wreathed in fire, and die like the goose in Mad Max. No, we're gonna go into Bleakfall's Barrow, and everyone can suck it. La 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 la. Okay, what we're gonna do here is this is where we are gonna use some of our some of our Eleusion. Which has been pointed out, they're really more enchantments than illusions. There we go. Use the fury there to thin the herd. And then we will burn the leftovers. You Triple H looking motherfucker. Ourselves to all this stuff. I'm going to be a bit more selective with stuff now since I've got quite a bit of it and we are running low on capacity. Oh, we can't really do that. So we are going to leave that. Snip, snip, snip. I'm glad we're doing this with some magic in tow though, some actual offensive magic, because the spider is that's coming up is not the funnest. Why am I doing it? Says empty, you fool. Remember, I first saw this quest played by Todd Howard at E3. I was very excited when I saw it. I'm clicking on the ones that say empty again. many years ago, me and Max Scoville at Destructoid, back when I was in Destructoid, when I was at Destructoid. Delightful. So, snake, shrimp. I know it's supposed to be a whale or something, but for some reason I always think shrimp when I see it. Snake, not particularly hard puzzles in this game. Move your fool. There we go. I always instinctively step back a bit just in case. It's good to get some adventuring under our belt, anyway. Thief, I'm reading thief. Again, with the empty fucking iron arrow. Gold. Delightful gold. I'll take that to sell it. Obviously, I don't know too much about soul gems because I'm not a conjurer by trade. Oh yeah, I forgot about that. Ban. Played our D&D session this weekend on the subject of adventuring and stuff. Scrabble a fireball, don't mind if I do. And that was fun. My character died. We had a new player, Kathy. She is just learning the ropes. Kind of didn't realise how helpful stabilising someone might be. I ended up rolling a 1 on my stabilisation check. This is D&D 5, 5th edition. And she had 10 healer's kits. Strange thirst as the sun sets. Had a healer's kit. Could have come over to stabilise me. Tried to explain the relative merits of that, considering I had 1 roll left to determine whether or not I'd die. And she chose instead to cast Minor Illusion. So that's how that fight went. I died. We had actually, though, luckily, our warlock, Jeff, had had an item that granted him a wish early on that had gotten picked up in some funny adventure thing. And actually wish my character back. And funnily enough, halfway through him doing that, I was already re-rolling stats for a new character. Rolled better stats, because the stats I rolled for my first character were kind of shitty. They were okay, it's just like perfectly average. He was Punisher as compared to Superman. And I rolled better stats. And the DM ruled, I guess just because the whole situation was a bit fucked up and it was a bit... I don't want to say unfair, but it was a bit... a bit shitty what had happened. Actually let me apply the new stats to my character, so my character died and was wished back better than ever. So it turned out okay. And so Malleus lives. And that's good.
You did it. You killed it. Now cut me down before anything else shows up.
All right, I will.
Yes, the claw. I know how it works. The claw, the markings, the door in the hall of stories. I know how they all fit together.
This guy, I believe this is the right guy, plays the guy whose name I can't remember, one of the bad guys from Bioshock Infinite, and also one of the big bads, I say big bads, one of the recurring villains in Angel, television's Angel. The vampire hunter, again, whose name I can't remember.
Does it look like I can move? You have to cut me down first.
You can't really.
It's coming loose. I can feel it.
Do much about him. He's gonna run away anyway.
You fool.
And then we're just gonna burn him.
No.
Arvel the swift. Arvel the cooked. Empty. Oh, no, not empty. God damn it. Why am I pressing all the wrong buttons? There. Okie dokie. See what that dickhead Arvo's got. Take Arvo's journal, I guess. Onward! Now we're gonna have some fun with Draugr. Draugr, I guess, is how you would say it. Oh god. There. Dead, 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 burn! Burn, I say! Listen to your undead master! It's just starting to sound like Skeletor. Die! There. Take the gold. Okay. Kill these sorry Draugr fucks. Amethysting pearls. Let's take the valuables for now. Avoid that. Restless Draugr. He looked like he was having a rest. He seemed to be having a lovely time. Ooh. Cheeky. Oh shit. No, 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 no. Okay. Restless Draugr, take two. Draugr, Draugr, Draugr. I never pronounce it right. Anyway. Hello? Come on. Come on! Shit. Burn, 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 burn. There we are, little tactical maneuvers, and everything's good. And we'll actually save the fucking thing. Well, fuck. They're just normal Draugr though. Draugr. Oh no no no, it got him. Haha, good. Come on. You wanna do it too? Delightful. And again, just to be safe. Runda Namambamba Mingot. Oh, I hate this. Fuck, I never timed those well. I end up just saying fuck it and running. Yeah, you and your magic appearing sword. My fighter's gonna be able to do that in D&D soon when I get the Eldritch Knight shit going. Fun times with friends. end of him. Burn. Burn like fish fingers that have been in the oven for too long. Valuable shield. Have enough great swords. As we continue through Bleak Fool's Barrow. Burning more Draugr. I'm so glad I got... Thank you all so much for voting for Destruction Magic. Having flames in the bank is nice. You can never have too many healy healies. Continue on. Finding all sorts of fun items. Eh, yeah, come on. Yeah, hairy testicle. By the way, if you're a fan of podcasts, I have a new one of those. I may upload the episodes fully to YouTube, to this channel. I've not decided yet. There is a new podcast in town. It's called Fist Shark Marketing. We're working on a nice website, and we're going to put it on iTunes. We're waiting for iTunes to approve it. It's an interesting podcast. It is a comedy podcast, sort of more comedy radio than anything else. Very polarizing opinions. Fans of my old Dismal Jesters podcast, who basically wanted the show to follow in that tradition, have been a bit disappointed. But a lot of newcomers and a lot of people who just kind of got the idea straight away are loving it. So, is this the right way? Yeah. So, yeah. People to whom it's resonating with are loving the shit out of it, which is awesome. Now I'm going to cough. something irritated me in the throat there. And Jim and the Arts is on Civil War. Is a new thing that's been going on. Just having a bit of a wander. Restless Draugr. They're not fun. We will just harry it from a distance as best we can. We should be able to make it out of this. It's catching up. Oh, slidey through. And this should drop him. There we go. Splendid! Yeah, Jim and the Arts is on Civil War on the Escapist, Escapist magazine. Launch two new things this weekend. Exciting time. And Civil War had an almost universally positive reaction, which was awesome. There's some people who complained about another Let's Play thing, which I find funny because on the Escapist itself, there's really not been that kind of content before. Certainly not much of it. So, I find that funny. Really, I mean, people complaining about it being another Let's Play wanted more of a debate, serious topic issue thing with the Artsy and I, which the Escapist already has plenty of. So in them accusing us and being angry at us not, like, doing the same old thing, they actually wanted the same old thing. So it was funny that it happened. Oh god. Oh shit. Oh, fuck! Fuck handle. I need to not play so fast and loose. Plus my illusion tricks are useless here against the Draugr. I should actually be a bit more careful about these as well. There we go. I never bother timing them properly. Fucking hell. Come on down here. Yeah, anus. That's it, come on. Through the fire and flames. Yes. That went much better. You know, deaths happen. Deaths happen. Especially if you're not paying attention. We'll take the resist card, but that is advanced potioneering. We can't just snipe it up without the perks. Okay. Here we go. The puzzle to end all puzzles. I don't know why they did these. I mean, I appreciate not having to sit around with all sorts of silly puzzles and things when I just want to kill dragons. Anyway, bear, dragonfly, is it? And owl looks, but it looks more like a fetus that's been embalmed. Anyway, bear, dragonfly, Venus. Oh, come on. Good stuff. Bloop. Fun. Let me get through. Oh yeah, there's some shit that's gonna go down here. Forgot about the shit. And the subsequent downing that it is about to go. No, no. The Draugr Overlord. Hello. Well, well, well. You know what that means? It means that's your lot. Yeah. Will I defeat the Draugr Overlord? I don't know why I went silent then. I don't know what I was expecting to come out of my head. I like that because that's a cliffhanger. So we will end it there and let you do the voting. You should know how this goes by now. One thing that I found funny was how in episode one, I wanted it all to be chaotic in the comments, and you kind of rebelled and set up your own form of order. So I said in episode two, okay, we'll have order, and then those comments were a mess. I don't know what it is about you people, but eventually Askefin stepped up and made a thread. So he'll know how this goes. Unless anyone beats him to the punch. I know several people tried to do the many replies, but I'm just going to go with which one of those reply threads is upvoted the most. So vote for whoever sets it out to your liking. You should know how it goes by now. There will be votes for health, magicka, and stamina. There will be votes for the various perks, you know, alteration, destruction, speechcraft, sneaky, heavy armor, weapons, all that kind of stuff. Vote for the attribute you want, vote for the perk I should spend, and that may change how we deal with the Draugr Overlord, or it may reinforce how we're already going to fight the Draugr Overlord. I don't know. It's up to Hjal. So thank you for being with me as always, my cheeky friends. Vote, and we'll see you next time on Skyrim by committee. Goodbye.